Hi folks, the Transformer we'll be reviewing today is G1 Ultra Magnus, which I'll just very carefully pick up. You can see here that Ultra Magnus transforms into a futuristic car carrier. Okay, this toy came from the Diaclone line, and as such, well, it came from a toy called Power Convoy, and as such, the cab unit is the same as Battle Convoy, which was the toy that was used as the model for Optimus Prime. Okay, so basically, the cab is the same as Optimus Prime. This figure here is a reissue, and you can see that it's a faithful reproduction of the original version of G1 Magnus with the rubber tires, the plastic windows, and later on in Robot Mode you'll see that it has a painted helmet. Alright, the other version of Ultra Magnus had plastic tires and an unpainted robot helmet. The colours, as you can see, are mostly blue, white and red, and you can see that one of the play features of the toy is that it actually holds up to four other Autobot cars. Okay, as it does as a car carrier, which means that Ultra Magnus can transport and deploy his own Autobot warriors into battle, as was meant to be shown in a deleted scene from Transformers the movie. Okay, so to use this, mode, we basically open up this ramp here, okay, and it's from here that the Autobot cars can roll in and out. Okay, you can see that the ramps are fairly well aligned with the width of their axles. Alright, so that's fairly good play value there. Again, you can see here these toys just simply roll out, and you can unlock this portion here, which will then allow the upper ramp to lower itself down. I'm trying to do this carefully. Okay. And as you can see, there you go, gravity does the rest of the work. Oops, there she goes. As the cars can then roll themselves out, or if you're as clumsy as I am, they just fall out. Okay, so again, you can see the idea is that the toys can roll out or they can roll in if you want to simulate Ultra Magnus loading or unloading his fellow Autobots. Okay, so that's the main play value there. Ultra Magnus has two robot modes. He has his small inner core robot, and then he has his armored robot mode, which is the more iconic symbol or image of Ultra Magnus's robot mode. Okay, to transform him into his core robot mode, we take his cab, and it essentially transforms exactly the same as G1 Optimus Prime. Alright, the legs swing down, feet swing up, the arms swing out, and hopefully you don't tear it off as I just did. But if you don't know why, just pop back in. Okay. And the head swings up. Alright. Then we simply attach on the fists, as you do with the G1 Prime. Now you can see here again, the robot head is painted on the version with the plastic wheels and no windows. The head is actually completely unpainted, it's totally white. You can see it actually has a completely different rifle from Optimus Prime. Part of this reason is that this rifle is also used by the armored robot mode, so it has two gun posts. Okay. Again, being a Diaclone figure, it has a driver's compartment which can hold two Diaclone pilots. So that's the core robot mode. Which is of course the basis of Masterpiece Ultra Magnus, Classics Ultra Magnus, and several other Ultra Magni, which have been repainted for Optimus Prime figures. Okay. as part of Hasbro Takara's continuing attempt to milk more money for us. Now, to transform this into his armored robot mode, you take the core robot and you transform the arms back as you would in cab mode, but the head and legs remain the same as in robot mode, and then you point the toes down like so, and the core robot is now ready to dock into his arm. Okay, so we take the trailer, and this will become the main power armor unit for Ultra Magnus. We remove the missile launchers. Okay, fold the upper ramp back up. Close the ramp doors. All right. The back portion folds in to become the lower legs. You see here that there's this plastic portion that is used as the hitch for the trailer. This comes off. I'm going to reattach it later. Okay, the upper ramp separates and then folds back over to form his arms. Okay, and then we simply shove that up, bend it at the elbows. Then from the back here, you can see two posts. This is where you stick in the headlight holes, which is normally where the fists go. Slot into those holes, just like that. And now we dress the figure up. Okay, we take the trailer hitch, which now goes into the crotch and now becomes Ultra Magnus' genitalia. Oh, I'm so immature. We now take the missile launcher, which goes into the holes on the sides of the shoulders. Okay. And then we take the main helmet, and that goes on top of the robot head. Okay. And finally, we take the main rifle and the main fists. Okay. And we place that into the wrists like so. And of course, we then take the chest plate, which is actually also a jet for a Diaclone pilot, which can sit here. Okay, in case you're wondering why it looks like a bit like an airplane. And there you have it, the armored robot mode for Ultra Magnus, which is iconically the robot mode for Ultra Magnus. Okay, from the front, it looks pretty impressive. Okay, it looks, although blocky, but by G1 standards, this is a fairly well-crafted figure. Okay, you have to remember that a lot of G1 toys are quite blocky and unarticulated robot mode. The back, again, completely exposes how it works. You can see the figure clearly just standing there. There's not much to hide it. The trailer is nothing more than a facade. But again, by G1 standards, this is not out of place. So, again, by G1 standards, it's actually not too bad. That's it there. You can see this missile launcher doesn't have a missile. The reason why I've done that is because this is actually the missile launcher from the reissue, from the Hasbro reissue, I should say. And you can see that the missile for the Hasbro reissue is far too long. It's oversized and it actually looks really bad, which is why I generally tend to prefer not having it there. Okay? My personal preference is that it's better without it. I prefer to stick in the, or even better, if you can stick in the original G1 launchers or Japanese reissue launchers, whichever you have, because it looks more accurate to the original toy. Alright, so that's the figure there. The original powered convoy toy came with a roller buggy that could also transform into a robot. Unfortunately, this toy was not included with Ultra Magnus. Alright, It's a fairly fun toy to play with. I always had fun playing with this toy as a kid. And as such an important and iconic character in the G1 mythos, I would highly recommend this toy in any Transformer collector's collection. Okay, there you go.